Hello everyone, you are watching Entrepreneurship Development with Ravind Hegde. Friends, if you go through the business history, we come across name of some persons who have emerged as successful entrepreneurs like Jahangir, Ratanji, Dadabhai Tata, JRD Tata, Dhirubhai Ambani of Reliance Industries, Narayan Murthy of Infosys, Lakshmi Nivas Mittal, Ajim Premji of Wipro, Andrew Carnegie, Warren Buffett, Henry Ford, Bill Gates of Microsoft, Larry Page of Google, Jeff Bezos, who is the founder and CEO of Amazon, and many more. The entrepreneurial profiles of these business or industry men are found quite fascinating. They are studied in a sharp contrast. How? Some are highly educated, others are high school or college dropouts, some are inheritors, others are self-made. Some stopped their chosen the field in their 30s, thus did not approach the starting line until their 50s. So there is no typical entrepreneur as such. Then the question is, what makes an entrepreneur successful? Whether they had anything in common? The scanning of their personalities shows that there are certain characteristics found in them. Today, let us discuss those characteristics of successful entrepreneurs. First one is hard work. Willingness to work hard distinguishes a successful entrepreneur from successful one. Most of the successful entrepreneurs work hard endlessly, especially in the beginning, and the same becomes their habit for their whole life. Success is not something that you run into by accident. It takes a lot of preparation and character. Everyone likes to win, but many are willing to put in the effort and time to prepare to win. It takes sacrifice and self-discipline. There is no substitute for hard work. Henry Ford said, "The harder you work, the luckier you get." The world is full of willing workers, but some willing to work and the others willing to let them. Some people say, "I like to work half a day. I don't care if it is the first 12 hours or the second 12 hours." So it is said by Kamens Wilson, who is the CEO of Holiday. Hard work and practice make a person better at whatever he is doing. Remember, one cannot develop a capacity to do anything without hard work, just as a person cannot learn how to spell by sitting on a dictionary, right? Professionals make things look easy because they have mastered the fundamentals of whatever they do. If people knew how hard I had to work to gain my mastery, it wouldn't seem wonderful at all. This was said by Michelangelo. The harder a person works, the better he feels. And the better he feels, the harder he works. very, very simple formula we have. The harder a person works, the better he feels. And the better he feels, the harder he works. It's a beautiful mantra of hard work. The best ideas will not work until you work the ideas. Greater talent without willpower and hard work is a waste. We need to learn from nature. You see, the duck keeps paddling relentlessly underneath what appears smooth and calm on top. A horse that pulls cannot kick, and horse that kicks cannot pull. So let us pull and stop kicking. Without hard work, there is no success. See, nature gives birds their food, but not put it in their nest. They have to work hard for it. Nothing comes easy. If you want, you can search in the Google. It took Noah Webster 36 years to complete Webster's dictionary. See, it's an example of hard work. Second characteristic is the desire for achievement. The entrepreneurs have a strong desire to achieve high goals in business. This high achievement motive strengthens them to surmount the obstacles, suppress anxieties, repair misfortunes, and devise experience and set up and run a successful business. Let me give an example. Sunil Mittal of Bharati Telecom presents an excellent example of need for high achievement. Sunil Mittal, the son of Sat Paul Mittal, a MP, belongs to non-business background, member of parliament. It was young Sunil, having high need for achievement in life, started with a business of making cycle parts in Ludhiana way back in 1976. At the age of 18, with borrowed capital of just 20,000 bucks. But things did not work properly, so he set up Bharati Healthcare in 1983, making capsules. It also did not work well because of the government's import-export policy. Then Sunil Mittal started to manufacture push-button telephones. You see the hard work. Since then, there was no looking back at all. It was Sunil's high need and urge for achievement. He bagged many firsts to his credit. The first push-button telephone and the first cordless, the first answering machine, the first fax machine. His entry into mobile sector with Airtel brand. I know you understood the Airtel. It's given by Sunil Mittal. In 1995 has made him really the spotlight in the mobile technology in the country. You just listen his mantra. One lives in proportion to what one sets and negotiates. One lives in proportion to what one sets and negotiates. And third characteristic is highly optimistic. The successful entrepreneurs have a positive approach towards things. Again, for this, the beautiful example is
Thomas Alva Edison. In 1914, Thomas Alva Edison, at the age of 67, lost his factory to fire. He had very little insurance. So no longer a young man. See, he is 67 now. He no longer a young man. Edison watched his lifetime effort to go up in smoke and said, "There is a great value in disaster. All our mistakes are burnt up. Thank God. Thank God. We can start anew. In spite of such a devastating disaster," 3 weeks after, he invented the phonograph. What an optimistic and positive attitude. See, the successful entrepreneurs do not get disturbed by the present problems faced by them. They become optimistic for future, that the situations will become favorable to use in future. And next feature is independence. One of the common qualities of successful entrepreneurs has been that they do not like to be guided by others and to follow their rules. They resist to be pigeonholed. They like to be independent in the matters of their business. Next is the foresight. The entrepreneurs have a good foresight to know about future business environment. In other words, they well visualize the likely changes to take place in the market, consumer attitude and taste, technological development and so on, and take necessary and timely actions accordingly. Let me give one beautiful example. Nagarao Ramarao Narayan Murthy, N.R. Narayan Murthy, presents an excellent example of business foresight. Why? I tell you. He pursued a career in computer science when there were not too many jobs in his field. The Indian industry was very much into motor and bikes business and had just about started appreciating the role of computers. Now, you know, today is the era of computers. So, Narayan Murthy presents an excellent example of business foresight. That means, even though there was lot of attraction towards bikes and motor industry, he started computer industry. Next is the good organizer. Various resources required for production are owned by different owners. So then it is the ability of the entrepreneur who brings together all required resources for setting up an enterprise and then produce goods. Next is the innovative. Production is meant to meet the customer's requirements. In view of the changing requirements of the customers, from time to time, the entrepreneurs initiate research and innovative activities to produce goods to satisfy the customers' changing requirements and demands for the products. The research centers or institutes established by Tata, Birla, Kirloskar, etc. are the good examples of the innovative activities taken by the entrepreneurs in our country. Here is an example of the innovative quality of late Dhirubhai Ambani. Late Dhirubhai Ambani started his textile company in India at the time when the textile industry in the country was facing absolutely unfavorable environment. The textile industry was suffering from the general recession in the country. The government policy was in support of small power loom units on the one hand and against the mill sector by imposing differential tax structure on the other. Expectedly, almost all small power loom entrepreneurs were criticizing the discriminatory policy of the government and demanding support from the government to protect them in the market. The entrepreneur, the Dhirubhai Ambani, with his uncanny knack, identified an opportunity even in such unfavorable environment. He realized that the small power loom units could produce goods with high quality, but we are finding it difficult to market them. So he decided to get high quality goods produced by these small power loom units as per his specification at a relatively low cost, got them duly processed and printed with the existing designs, and then sold them under his widely accepted brand in the market. He earned huge margins of profits by doing so. Next quality is perseverance. One of the qualities of successful entrepreneurs is that they possess and exhibit tremendous perseverance in their pursuits. They do not give up their efforts even if they fail. It can make miracles happen. They undergo lots and lots of failures, but do not become disheartened. Instead, they take failure as learning experience and make more dedicated and serious effort on the next time and ultimately become successful. Example of Sunil Mittal, given earlier under desire for high achievement, is an example of entrepreneurial perseverance also. Friends, let me share another excellent example of perseverance. Miss Fanny Hurst. Miss Fanny, F-E-N-N-Y-H-U-S-T. You can search in a Google also. Miss Fanny Hurst, a creative writer, has a goal to get her story published in the famous magazine of that time. Her 37 stories were rejected by that magazine. But she persisted in her efforts. Her 38th story was published by that magazine. From her story, a play was produced and she earned lots of royalties, and afterwards she had not to look back. So perseverance can make miracles happen. So next is, before giving the next quality, let us see a beautiful poem, Don't Quit. You can search in the Google and you can buy it also. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you are trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. See, Life is a cure with its twists and turns, as every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure turns about when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up. Though the pace seems slow, you may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt, and you never can tell how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when you are hardest hit. It's when things seem worse that you must not quit. See, what a beautiful poem about perseverance. Don't quit. Next quality is team spirit. The word team means together, everyone achieves more. Team indicates T for together, E for everyone, A for achieves, M for more. So team indicates together, everyone achieves more. Successful entrepreneurs build teams and work with teammates. Working in teams creates synergy and achieves success in its endeavors. While appreciating the role of team spirit in success, Henry Ford's apt view seems worth citing. Bringing people together is beginning. Keeping people together is progress. And working with people is success. Ajim Premji, 10 golden rules for a successful entrepreneur is: dare to dream, set clear goals, never lose your zest and curiosity for learning, strive for excellence, learn to work in teams, take care of yourself, persevere, have a broader social vision, never let success go to your head. Now, let me give a story of team spirit. It's a very beautiful story. Now you understood what is the meaning of team, right? Team indicates together, everyone achieves more. Together, everyone achieves more. Here is a story of hare and tortoise that best illustrates the role of team spirit in achieving success. Let us learn the good old lessons in teamwork from an age-old fable, the tortoise and the hare. Once upon a time, a tortoise and hare had an argument. Who was faster? One is saying, that's not true. I'm the faster runner. Oh no, I'm the faster runner. They decided to settle the argument with a race. They agreed on a route and started off the race. Fine. Okay, let us have a race now. The hare shot ahead and ran briskly for some time. Then, seeing that he was far ahead of the tortoise, he thought he would sit under a tree for some time and relax before continuing the race. She is thinking, poor guy, even if I take a nap, he could not catch up with me. He sat under the tree and soon fell asleep. The tortoise, plodding on, overtook him and soon finished the race. emerging as the undisputed champ. The hare woke up and realized that he would have lost the race. The moral of the story is that slow and steady wins the race. So this is the version of the story that you all grown up with. Everyone knows this version. The story continues. The hare was disappointed at losing the race and he did some soul searching. He realized that he would have lost the race only because he had been overconfident, careless, and lax. If he had not taken things for granted, there is no way the tortoise could have beaten him. So he challenged the tortoise to another race. The tortoise agreed. Yes, okay, fine. Because it is enjoying the situation. This time, the hare went all out and ran without stopping from start to finish. He won by several miles this time. So the moral of the story is, fast and consistent will always beat the slow and steady. If you have two people in your organization, one slow, methodical and reliable, and the other fast and still reliable, what he does, the fast and reliable champion will consistently climb the organizational ladder faster than the slow, methodical step. So it is good to be slow and steady, but it is better to be fast and reliable. But the story does not end here. The tortoise did some thinking this time and realized that there is no way he can beat the hare in a race the way it was currently formatted. The tortoise is thinking, how can I defeat the hare? He thought for a while and then challenged the hare to another race, but on a slightly different route. The hare agreed. Now the hare knows what is the strength, what is my weakness. I should not sleep anywhere. I have to run from start to finish. So the hare knows the secret. Can you have another race? This time we will go through different route. The hare said, sure. They started off. In keeping with his self-made commitment to be consistently fast, the hare took off and ran at top speed until he came to a broad river. The finishing line was a couple of kilometers on the other side of the river. The goal is on the other side. The hare sat there wondering what to do. In the meantime, the tortoise trundled along, got into the river, swam to opposite bank, continued walking and finished the race. See, what is the moral? First, identify your core competency and then change the playing field to suit your core competency. In an organization, if you are a good speaker, make sure you create opportunities to give presentations that enable the senior management to notice you. If your strength is analysis, make sure you do some sort of research, make a report and send it upstairs. Working to your strengths will not only get you noticed, but will also create opportunities for growth and achievement. The story still has not ended. The hare and tortoise by this time had become pretty good friends and they did something thinking together. Both realized that the last race could have been run much better. So they decided to do the last race again, but to run as a team this time. Great, I think we could do it much better if we two help each other. They started off, and this time the hare carried the tortoise till the river bank. There, in the river, the tortoise took over and swam across with the hare on his back. On the opposite bank, the hare again carried the tortoise and they reached the finishing line together. They both felt a greater sense of satisfaction than they would felt earlier. So the moral of the story is, it's good to be individually brilliant and to have a strong core competencies, but unless you are able to work in a team and harness each other's core competencies, you will always perform below par, because there will always be situations at which you will do poorly and someone else does well. Teamwork is mainly about situational leadership, letting the person with the relevant core competency for a situation take leadership. So there are more lessons to be learned from this story. Notice that neither the hare nor the tortoise gave up after failures. The hare decided to work harder and put in more effort after his failure. The tortoise changed his strategy because he was already working as hard as he could. In life, when faced with failure, sometimes it is appropriate to work harder and put in more effort. Sometimes it is appropriate to change strategy and try something different. And sometimes it is appropriate to do both. The hare and the tortoise also learned about vital lesson. When you stop competing against a rival and instead start competing against the situation, we perform better. To sum up, the story of the hare and the tortoise teaches many things. Never give up. When faced with failure, fast and consistent will always beat slow and steady. Work to your competencies. Compete against the situation, not against a rival. Pooling resources and working as a team will always beat individual performance. So let us go and build stronger teams. Thank you. Have a nice time.